I didn't mistype, you didn't misread. This is genuinely going to be a dream story about me having a lucid dream last night in the Minecraft world. There's a lot to cover, so let's just jump into it, shall we? I was finishing a live stream on Twitch last night, which I've been doing quite a lot of. So if you want to see that, twitch.tv/GizEdward, shameless plug. All the times and information is found in the description box below. Come join us. It's great. So I'm finishing up a stream, and then I go to bed. And just as I'm going to bed, I think, do I need to go to the toilet? Nah, it's okay. Because I have a special superpower in which I can hold in a pee overnight. If I need to go for a wee before I go to bed, I can hold it in during my sleep and wake up the next morning and just go for a pee, just as a normal human being. This information is vital for this story, so that's a thing. I wake up pretty early because the cat is nibbling my ear and licking my face for some reason, and I go back to sleep. That was about 6:30, and I go back to sleep, and I don't wake up until about 11:30, so I had a huge chunk of sleep, and this is really good for lucid dreams. So I'm in this dream, and I'm running. I'm not lucid at this point. I'm running on top of some roofs of houses in the dark, and I'm running, and I'm just jumping from house to house, making the gaps, and trying to run away from something. And that's when I realized I'm running away from this guy, and I turn around, and he looks a little bit like, how do I describe this? He looks a little bit like Assassin's Creed characters, where he's all in the get-up. He's got the garbs of the Assassin's Creed character, but instead of it being like a beige color, it's more like a dark red or a black kind of outfit, like a mixture of the two, kind of like how you would think a ninja vampire would dress. That's how he dressed, and he was chasing me. And when I looked forward, I found my friend in waking life who was in front of me, and I was like, okay, I'll chase them down. I'll keep chasing them so that they can lead to somewhere else. As I was running along these roofs, going in between the different gaps, I realized that there was also the road that was parallel to these roofs were going up on an incline, but the houses were staying the same. So it was like it was going underground almost. And it got to a point where the level of the roofs and the level of the pavement outside was even. So we just ran on the pavement and went into the first house that we could see on the left. So we're in this house. I closed the door, locked it up. It's still dark, still sketchy. And I turn around, and my friend's gone. And I'm like, what the hell? I need to go and find this person. So I'm walking through the house, walking around, and that's when I realize I need to go for a pee. So I'm like, okay, I hope that there's a bathroom behind this door. So I open the door, and there's a bathroom. And I think, that's quite weird. And I close the door. And as soon as I close the door, I realize I'm dreaming. And that's something I've noticed since I've stopped doing lucid dreaming. All of my lucid dreams that I have are very spontaneous, and I don't really need to have, like, I don't need to test anything. I don't need to kind of examine whether or not I'm in a dream. If I feel like I'm lucid, I know that I'm in a dream automatically. It'll be like, I'm lucid. Oh, I'm dreaming. I know this is a dream. I don't need to double check. I can just tell. And everything is spontaneous and to the point. So I walk into this bathroom. There's a toilet in front of me. There's a bath in one corner, there's a shower in the other corner, a sink in the other corner. And I turn around to close the door, bearing in mind I just become lucid at this point. And when I turn around to see the toilet, the room has changed. So instead of it being a big room with a shower, a bath, a toilet, a sink, I turn around after closing the door, and I'm just in like a long skinny corridor, and there's just the toilet at the end. And I turn around and I'm just, you know, there's enough space for me to sit down on the toilet and rest my head against the door. There's not anything around. So I'm lucid and I'm sitting on this toilet and I'm trying to pee. And I'm thinking, I probably shouldn't be peeing, because if I pee here, chances are I might pee myself in bed. When I stopped peeing, I then realized that the world around me was starting to kind of like fade away. Like the dream was disappearing. And I thought, I don't want a dream to disappear. What I'll do is I'll take my own advice from my own videos. I'll start touching the walls and start trying to enforce myself within a dream, trying to induce as many senses as I can to kind of pin me to this dream. So that's exactly what I do. I touch the radiator because I know that the radiator is smooth. I know the radiator paint would be silky. I know that the radiator itself is made out of metal, so therefore it will be cold. So I grabbed the top, and it was smooth, it was silky, it was cold, and I start rubbing the radiator, kind of like a genie's lamp, you know, that kind of thing. And when I did that, the world got warped and distorted. And the best way to describe it, if anybody's ever seen Minecraft or played Minecraft, is when you go through a nether portal. And it was like I went through a nether portal. And when I let go of the radiator, I was in the Minecraft world. So everything was square blocks. Everything was like Minecraft blocks. Kind of like how a Lego film is made completely out of real Lego pieces. My Minecraft world was made out of real Minecraft stuff. I opened the door. It made the noise of the door. I walked through it. I'm a Minecraft character. The bathroom's a Minecraft scene. Everything is Minecraft. And I think, I've got to find my friend. So I opened the door to the outside, and instead of being in the street, I'm in water, and I'm swimming along, and I have to go down, and I'm swimming down and down and down, bearing in mind, Minecraft. So I'm swimming down and down, I see coral reefs, I see the blocks, I see gravel, I see sand, and I'm swimming down and down and down towards a temple, which is an underwater monument that you get in Minecraft, and there's all these guardians coming towards me. There's, well, they're not really guardians. They look like squid or jellyfish. They look more like jellyfish, but you don't get jellyfish in Minecraft. And the best way I could describe it was a mixture between the squid that you get in Minecraft and a guardian. So I hit it with my fist and it died in one hit. And I thought, oh, great, that's perfect. And then I hit another one, but I hit its tail, like the tendrils, instead of the head of the jellyfish type thing. And it didn't die. And I thought, okay, that's weird. So I punched the top of it and it died. And then they all started coming towards me like that. And they were all going towards me. So I had to keep swimming further and further down. Meanwhile, I'm lucid. I'm not like in any false pretense that this isn't a dream. I know this is a dream. So I'm swimming down thinking this is mental. And I'm swimming and I'm punching these jellyfish as I'm swimming down further and further. And then I find a door underwater and I open the door and go into the street that I was in originally. But all of the houses are like villager houses. And I'm running just like I was at the beginning of the dream, jumping from roof to roof, jumping from roof to roof, trying to run away from this thing that's coming behind me. And I turn around, there's no sea anymore. I can't see the door. I'm running away from this same like vampire ninja, but he is a Minecraft character instead. So I'm running across these walls and these houses, running away from this Minecraft character. And I see my friend, and she's a Minecraft character. And then all of a sudden, I wake up because somebody is knocking at my front door of my house. Disgusting behavior. Here's a weird thing as well. I get up from, like, being rudely woken up by this person. I get up. I go towards the door. I put a dressing gown on because I can't find my clothes. And I go towards the door and open it. No one's there. So they must have just knocked on the door and just gone, there is nobody here. Because there was no waiting. They just knocked and left. But then I look out my window and I see that this person is like a clipboard type person. And she's just gone to a different house. But I'm like, give it time. Even the postman knocks twice, you know? One thing I did forget to mention was that when I was in the bathroom and everything had just turned into Minecraft, I was like hitting the wall and it was creating like the fractured wall. Like when you're breaking a block in Minecraft, it kind of breaks slowly and the texture changes. And then I stopped and it just healed itself. That's what it was doing. It was a really weird dream, really interesting. I think it means that I have been playing so much Minecraft recently that it's kind of infected my brain. And even now my dreams are Minecraft. So if you want to watch me stream Minecraft, links in the description box below. Thank you very much for watching, and I don't know when I'll make another video, but you never know when inspiration strikes, eh? So until next time.